the Sahaba understand it is our objective, our goal to reach our optimum. The best that we can be is if we follow them. And Allah has testified their standard many, many times in the Quran. Allah says, لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ يُبَايِعُونَكَ تَحْتَ الشَّجَرَةِ فَعَلِمَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ وَأَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْهِمْ فَأَثَابَهُمْ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, most certainly Allah was happy and pleased with those companions who gave pledge to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم under the tree. فَأَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْهِمْ. And then Allah sent down upon them tranquility and peace. فَأَثَابَتُمْ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا. And Allah has promised them a near and close victory. This is the month of victory, brothers. The month of Ramadan brings about the victory. The month of Ramadan, the 17th day of Ramadan, Battle of Badr. And if I'm not mistaken, the 28th day of Ramadan or the 27th, Fath al-Makkah. And many other historical battles took place. So we are followers of the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we should take pride in this. Their call was Rabbana إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا. Allah says, our Lord say that we have heard the one calling to Iman, meaning the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was calling to the people and saying, say you believe in your Lord. فَآمَنَّا. And we have believed. We are the sons of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. من أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه؟ من كان أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه؟ وذا إيمان of أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه was to be placed on one side of the scale, and for the إيمان of the entire Ummah to be placed on the other side of the scale, including Umar, Uthman, Ali, and the rest. The إيمان of أبو بكر الصديق will be heavier, greater. We're talking about the greatest man ever to walk the face of the earth. After the Anbiya, we love Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. The next man in line, who is the next man after Abu Bakr Siddiq? Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, Amir al-Mu'minin. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لو كان نبي بعدي لكان عمر. Had there been a prophet after me, it would have been Umar. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا ابن الخطاب, O son of al-Khattab. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. By the one in whose hand is my soul. مَا لَقِيقَ الشَّيْطَانُ سَالِكًا فَجًّا قَطُّ إِلَّا سَلَكَ فَجًّا خَيْرَ فَجِّكَ. Allahu Akbar. Never does shaitan take a path when he sees you taking a path, but he takes another path. He's scared of Umar ibn Khattab, the real gangster, the real hard man. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu. Who was the next man in line after Umar ibn Khattab? Uthman ibn Affan, Dhu-Nurain, the one who was married to two of the daughters of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the one who, while he was fasting, reading the Quran, his blood was spilt on the Mus'haf while he was reading the Quran, he was murdered. And one of the narrations from Umar, Uthman ibn Affan, he says, خَيْرُكُمْ مِنْكُمْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ عَلَّمَ وَعَلَّمَ. The best amongst you are those who learn the Quran and teach it. So learn the Quran and become the best by teaching the Quran to others, like it was taught to us. We are the sons of Ali ibn Abu Talib, the fourth greatest man, the final of the Khulafa al-Rashidin. من كان علي بن أبو طالب at the tender age of seven or eight, he became a Muslim. Seven or eight. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited his uncles to give them da'wah to Islam. They laughed and mocked at him. Ali radiallahu anhu comes to the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I believe in you. That Ali is the most famous man from the gathering after the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. None of these uncles we remember. None of them. The only one we can think of is Abu Lahab, who is the perished one. Tabbat yada Abi Lahabi wa tab. Ali ibn Abu Talib. These are our heroes. And we bear these names. And once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, ألا ترضى أن تكون مني بمنزلة هارون من موسى إلا أنه ليس نبي بعدي. Are you not happy, Ya Ali, that you are to me as Harun alayhi salam was to Musa alayhi salam, except that there is no prophet after me? So Ali radiallahu anhu was close to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one of the closest companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was a cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was the best of Banu Hashim after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was married to his beloved daughter Fatima bint Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allahu Akbar. Brothers, tamanna, wish. Make a wish now. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu asks his people, tamanna, like this. One person says, I wish this room was full of gold and silver so I can spend it fi sabilillah. The Amir al-Mu'mini says, tamanna. Again he says, wish. One of them says, I wish this room was full of pearls and gems so I can spend it fi sabilillah. And again, Amir al-Mu'mini says, tamanna, wish. And they said, we can't think of anything else, Ya Amir al-Mu'mini. Anta tamanna, Ya Amir al-Mu'mini. You wish now. Atamanna bil ahad al-fursan ka Abi Ubaida. I wish this room was full of the likes of horsemen like Abu Ubaida ibn al-Jarrah, radiallahu anhu. One of the Ashat al-Mubashirin. One of the biggest names in Islam after the Khulafa al-Rashidin. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لكل أمة أمينا وأيتها الأمة أبو عبيدة بن الجراح رضي الله عنه. Every nation has a trustee, most trustworthy person. The most trustworthy person in our ummah is Abu Ubaida ibn al-Jarrah رضي الله عنه. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, whenever he remembered Battle of Uhud, he used to say, ذَلِكَ كُلُّهُ يَوْمُ طَلْحَ. That day, all of it belongs to Talha radiallahu anhu. Because Talha radiallahu anhu defended the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the Battle of Uhud. The most awkward hour in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was hurt physically, blood flowing down his body. Talha protected him, got injured himself, carried him. Subhanallah. That was Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. Man kana Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, who is a cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At the age of 13, he becomes a Muslim. 13. I wish I was 13 again and heard these stories of Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna li kulli nabiyyin hawari wa inna hawari Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. Aw kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, every prophet has a close companion, and my closest companion Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. We have Sa'ad ibn Abu Waqqas in Battle of Uhud. The Prophet gave him an arrow to protect him. And every time he gave him an arrow, he says, shoot, Ya Sa'ad, may my mother and father be sacrificed for you. Some of the narration says, the Prophet uttered this 100 times to Sa'ad ibn Abu Waqqas. Another young companion. Abdurrahman ibn Awf. The most wealthiest companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the 10 names are this. Remember these brothers and sisters. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab, Uthman ibn Affan, Ali ibn Abu Talib, Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah, Sa'ad ibn Abu Waqqas, Abdurrahman ibn Awf, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, and Sa'id ibn Zayd. These were the blessed companions who were given the glad tidings of paradise while they were walking on this earth. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Don't be sad. Don't grieve. You will have the upper hand. You will become victorious. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are true believers.